AI to decode how animals communicate. With the help of artificial intelligence algorithms, scientists recently revealed that they translated pig grunts into emotions for the first time, which could help them monitor animal well-being. Experts have claimed that research could also be used to better understand the emotions of other mammals. The researchers are using AI to parse the speech of animals. This method will help scientists to create systems that decode animal sounds. For example, such algorithms might help to detect and monitor whale songs so that nearby ships can be alerted to avoid collisions. These researchers of animal communication are using a branch of AI called self-supervised learning. In recent years, self-supervised learning has proven effective for handling human language. It learns from unlabeled data and can be regarded as an intermediate form between supervised and unsupervised learning, based on artificial neural networks. Self-supervised learning shows promise as a way to process the immense quantities of animal communication captured in laboratories as well as natural environments. With constant advancements in technology, there is no exaggeration in saying that such results, where humans will be able to communicate with animals, are achievable in the near future. Researchers in Germany even developed an AI-based system called BirdNet that can now identify more than 3,000 different species of birds by their calls. Artificial intelligence tool may help to predict heart attacks. Scientists developed an AI algorithm to measure coronary plaque buildup. The tool accurately predicted which patients would experience a heart attack in 5 years based on the amount of composition of plaque in the arteries that supply the blood to the heart. Plaque buildup can cause arteries to narrow, which make it difficult for blood to get to the heart, increasing the likelihood of a heart attack. A medical test called a coronary computed tomography angiography, or CTA, takes 3D images of the heart and arteries and can give doctors an estimate of how much a patient's arteries have narrowed. Until now, however, there has not been a simple, automated, and rapid approach to measure the plaque visible in the CTA images. Because of this, coronary plaque is often not measured because there is no fully automated way to do it. When it is measured, it takes an expert at least 25 to 30 minutes, but now the AI program can quantify plaque from CTA images in 5 to 6 seconds. The CTA images from 1,196 people were used to train the AI algorithm to measure plaque by having it learn from coronary CTA images. The algorithm works by first outlining the coronary arteries in 3D images, then identifies the blood and plaque deposits within the coronary arteries. Measurements made by the AI algorithm from CTA images accurately predicted heart attack risk within 5 years for 1,611 people who were part of a multi-center trial called the SCOAT Heart Trial. More studies are needed, but it's looking increasingly possible to predict if and how soon a person is likely to have a heart attack based on the amount and composition of the plaque imaged in the standard test. NVIDIA reveals H100 GPU for AI and teases world's fastest AI supercomputer, all built on the company's new Hopper architecture. NVIDIA announced a slew of AI-focused enterprise products, including details for its new silicon architecture called Hopper, the first data center GPU built on that architecture, the H100, a new Grace GPU superchip, and vague plans to build what the company claims will be the world's fastest AI supercomputer, named EOS. NVIDIA says its Hopper architecture is specialized to accelerate the training of transformer models on H100 GPUs by 6 times compared to previous generation chips, while the new fourth generation NVIDIA NVLink can connect up to 256 H100 GPUs at 9 times higher bandwidth than previous generations. The H100 GPU itself contains 80 billion transistors and is the first GPU to support PCIe Gen 5 and utilize HBM3, enabling memory bandwidth of 3 terabytes per second. NVIDIA says the H100 GPU is 3 times faster than its previous generation A100 and 6 times faster at 8-bit floating point math. For the training of giant transformer models, H100 will offer up to 9 times higher performance, training in days what used to take weeks. The company also announced a new data center CPU, the Grace CPU superchip, which consists of 2 CPUs connected directly to serve giant-scale high-performance computing and AI applications alongside the new Hopper-based GPUs, and can be used for CPU-only systems as well as GPU-accelerated servers. It has 144 ARM cores and 1 terabyte per second of memory bandwidth. The company also teased that it was building a new AI supercomputer named EOS, built using the Hopper architecture and contains some 4,600 H100 GPUs to offer 18.4 exaflops of AI performance. The EOS supercomputer, when running traditional supercomputer tasks, would rack 275 petaflops of compute, which is 1.4 times faster than the fastest science computer in the United States. They expect EOS to be the fastest AI computer in the entire world, and plan for it to be the blueprint for the most advanced AI infrastructure for their OEMs and cloud partners. Magnetic tentacle robot could slink around inside patients' lungs. This image shows a life-size model of a bronchial tree with a flexible magnetic tentacle robot for size. Human lungs are a maze, and bronchial tubes can be a tight squeeze. Navigating through them for medical procedures is a delicate and challenging activity. A team led by researchers at the University of Leeds created a proof-of-concept robot that can navigate some of the smallest bronchial tubes. The tentacle-like device under development is controlled by magnets on robotic arms set up outside of the patient. It's more maneuverable than a bronchoscope and uses an autonomous system to guide it, essentially working with a custom map of the patient's lungs to get where it needs to go. A magnetic tentacle robot or catheter that measures 2 millimeters and whose shape can be magnetically controlled to conform to the bronchial tree anatomy can reach most areas of the lung and would be an important clinical tool in the investigation and treatment of possible lung cancer and other lung diseases. The team put the magnetic tentacle robot through tests using a 3D replica of a bronchial tree. The next step is to try the device in the lungs of a cadaver before trying it on living patients. South Korea's major shipbuilders are introducing robots to overcome a lack of manpower to cut steel materials and weld them into blocks. During the sub-block assembly, a human employee works with the so-called collaboration robots instead of being fully replaced by automation. These collaboration robots can detect collisions, allowing employees to work with them without setting up a safety fence. The robots have reportedly raised overall productivity by 40%. Hyundai Samho Heavy Industries Co. Shipyard also plans to deploy a 13-kilogram robot for welding. Thanks to its miniature size, the robot can reach into narrow spaces inside the ship to carry out surgical welding tasks. The robot is also capable of weaving, a highly difficult welding skill that requires the torch to move in a zigzag direction, which means that even an unskilled worker can utilize the robot to carry out difficult tasks. Daewoo Shipbuilding and Marine Engineering Co. is using robots to automatically install electric wires inside ships or marine plants. The company said it now saves more than $1.64 million each year, and the use of robots prevents workers from suffering from certain diseases. Self-driving trucks will leave 500,000 unemployed, studies warn. Driverless trucks could replace 90% of human drivers over the coming years, according to a new research into advances in self-driving technology. The study from the University of Michigan and Carnegie Mellon University found that up to 500,000 human jobs in the U.S. could be replaced by the introduction of autonomous driving systems for long sections of interstate driving. The study is the first to combine geospatial analysis based on shipment data with an explicit consideration of the specific capabilities of automation and how those might evolve over time. The researchers were surprised to find that many of the truck drivers interviewed for the study agreed that large parts of their job could be replaced by a robot. A key finding was just how economically attractive this technology would be, and the fact that everyone, including truckers, agreed that the interstate part of the job could be automated.